decrease as you increase, O Lord. We open up our hearts to you that you speak to us. We ask you, Holy Spirit, that you illuminate our hearts and quicken our hearts to hear that which you want us to hear, O God. And we pray that you speak to us in a special way and remind us, rebuke us, correct us, exhort us, O Lord. And we all give all this to you, and we give you all the glory and honor with thanksgiving in our hearts. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So it's so wonderful, wonderful, wonderful to come in the presence. I'm going to consider a question. And the question is, when prayer no longer appeals, when praying to God no longer appeals to you, that's the question that we are going to unpack and answer and bring some answers to the question of scripture. And I don't know about you, there are moments in life when you feel like, oh. One of the questions they asked Desmond Tutu to say, when all this thing is finished and then you appear before the Lord, what can you say? And he said, oh, what a life, but it was worth it. Hmm. He said, what a life, what a journey, but it is worth it. Amen. So our Christian life is a journey. It's not a one-day thing. It's a journey. And we will see in the worship of scripture, when praying no longer appeals, when praying to God no longer appeals, the question is, why? What are those things that causes us not to continue praying, or that causes us not to engage with God and not continue to ask in the Lord? There are a lot of obstacles that happens in our lives that can cause that. The obstacles, some of them claim that they don't have enough time. That's what some people say, oh, I cannot pray to God because I don't have enough time. But and yet, we easily have other times for other things. You can spend 2 hours or 1 hour watching a movie, but when it comes to seeking the face of God, we find it so hard. But there are some factors that can cause all that. And sometimes people say, I don't have time because I live a busy life. My life is busy. I don't have time. And we give such kind of excuses. But when we look at Jesus, sometimes he had sleepless nights. Early in the morning, the Bible tells us when you read the gospel that early in the morning he was to the mountains, seeking the mind of God, praying to his Father to ask him what the day will be. He will slip away. There will be a multitude be following him and following Rabbi, Rabbi, teacher, but he will slip away and go to the adequate place, talking to his Father. And the Bible tells us that the Son of God would not do anything unless that which his Father was doing. He would not do anything until he slips away and go to see his face. The question is, what do we slip away to when we have enough time? What do we say, oh, this time I have, let me just slip away and do some shopping. And all of a sudden, suddenly it takes you 2 hours, and then you come back and say, oh, I meant to read the portion of scripture, but I can't go on. When praying no longer appears, we give a lot of excuses. Or maybe you live in a crowded accommodation. Oh, the problem is that I live in a crowded accommodation and a lot of noise. I can't have time. You can create time for the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
You can get a walk. One of the things that I love in life is taking the walks in the park. And there we talk to God. When you look at the nature, what God has created, the wonders of the trees. For example, nowadays when you go in the park, when I used to walk into them, they were so dry, and you would think that there would be no life coming. But when I walk into the park nowadays, I would see the green. And the Bible says the creations declare the glory of the risen God. It's not that I'm praying to the creation, I'm exhorting the Lord for what I'm seeing with my eyes. So you can slip away. And after that time, the question is, what do you slip away to? Is it to watch a football game? Or is it to watch a soccer? What do you sleep away to? The Son of God slept away to go and be with his Father. When prayer no longer appears. So we can create that moment. We can create that time to seek the Lord. The other thing is that we must learn to keep our appointment to meet with God whenever we feel like it or not. It is a, for example, if you are, Pastor Kuna always tells us, if you are given an appointment to see your GP, or you are given a prescription to say you go to the doctor and get this medicine, you don't just sit. You don't just go to the doctor and say, oh, this is a medical prescription. I'm fine. No, you take a step by going to the pharmacy, getting that medication, and then you read the instruction, and then you begin to follow the instruction. If we can do that and then we achieve the results, what about the Lord? We have a manual which has been given to us to redirect our lives, to direct our lives in whatever we want to do. This is the manual. It has all the answers. If we are able even to know that on such and such a day I'm going to shift, you know in advance. But what about the word that gives life? The word that sustains us. The word that created all things. Brothers and sisters, we need to create time for us to meet with the Maker. It's a deliberate move. It's a choice that each one of us has to make. As much as we can be encouraged, as much as we can be prompted, as much as we can have people that we look up, as much as we can listen to the word of God in heaven, but we have a duty to create an appointment with God ourselves. And God will meet you at the point of your need. When you create that atmosphere, and then you allow God in that moment, he will speak to you. We must learn to keep appointment with God. Make it a little bit. Walk out 1 hour. Begin with just 10 minutes. Begin with 20 minutes. And there you keep on building. And not just the way we are here. Life is so busy, you can be caught up. And then bit by bit, you begin to lose your faith. So, when prayer no longer appears. It is by faith and not by faith, brothers and sisters. It is not by faith, it is by faith. It is by faith and not by faith. It's not by faith. It's not the way I feel when I'm out there, I feel like exhausted. Even when you don't feel like it, that is even the moment for you to speak the word. Even when you feel disappointed, it's so easy when you are disappointed to just slip away into negative. Slip away into, oh, I know that this will happen. And slip away into grumbling. Slip away into pity. Slip away into hopelessness. It's so easy. But when we look to him and trust him, God will make him.
Amen.
God is faith. God is faith. Now I want to consider 8 things that can help us when praying appears. When praying seems not to appear in our lives. When praying no longer appears. Number one, the Bible says prayer is more than a suggestion. It is a command.
Amen.
It's more than a suggestion, it's a command. Luke chapter 18. Jesus Christ himself told the disciples. Luke 18 verse 1. The Bible says, then Jesus told the disciples a parable to show them that they should always pray and not give up. Amen.
Amen.
So, when prayer no longer appears, remember this, prayer is more than a suggestion. It's not a suggestion. It's more than that. It is a command. We are commanded. Luke 18, the Bible says, then Jesus told the disciples a parable to show them that they should always pray and not give up.
Amen.
Amen. So when you feel that you don't want to seek the Lord, when you don't want to pray to God, it is a command that you have to. It is a command. Because it is you, only your benefit. It is you who is benefiting. It's not God. It's you who is growing in that moment. And not to give up. Why? Because it's so easy to give up. And God here gives an example. He gives an example. He said, in a certain town there was a judge who neither feared God nor cared about men. And there was a widow in that town who kept coming to him with a plea. Grant me justice against my adversary. For some time he refrained. But finally he said to himself, even though I do not fear God or care about man, yet because this widow keeps bothering me, I will see that she gets justice so that she won't eventually wear me out with her coming. You see the persistence. It's the persistence. You see? Oh, sometimes they say, oh no, I asked the Lord in the last year and it never happened. No, the Bible says, keep on asking and you shall have. Keep on knocking and you shall receive. That's why when we come to our Lord Jesus Christ, it's not a one-off. Once you gave your life to God, you have to keep on believing until when the day comes, the Lord will take you home.
Amen.
And that's how, and that's the way we live. And that's the way of a Christian life, is to keep on and look at the tenacity of the woman. And look at what the church says. Even though I do not fear God, but because of her boldness. In the same book of Luke 11, there's a man who went to his friend to say, I've received some visitors, please wake up and give me the bread. And the Bible says, he said, I'm sleeping and my children are sleeping. There's no way I can wake up. But the Bible says, well, the man kept on knocking. He kept on knocking at the door until the man who was inside woke up and gave him what he wanted. So bear in mind that prayer is more than a suggestion. It is a command.
Amen.
That we continue and not give up.
Amen.
Prayer is to be perpetual and not merely occasional.
Amen.
Amen. It's a perpetual thing. It's not an occasion. It's, oh, when I feel better. Or when I feel that all is well. That's when I'm telling you. No. It's a perpetual. When you woke up, you are talking to God. When you are doing whatever, washing up dishes, you are talking to God. Father, thank you, Jesus, that I can see. Thank you, Jesus, that this is the day that you have made. I will rejoice and be glad. Thank you that I will rejoice. Thank you that you have gone before me. Thank you that you have made this day. Thank you that I can see. Thank you that I can walk. Thank you that my hands are able to wait. It is a perpetual and not merely occasion. Psalm 105 verse 4. The Bible says in Psalm 105 verses 4.
Seek the Lord
and
his
strength,
his
face,
for
evermore. Amen. Amen. So prayer is to be perpetual and not merely occasional. The Bible says, look to the Lord and his strength. Seek his face always. Always. Psalms 105 verse 4. Always. And we are commanded to seek the Lord always. And that's where we get the strength. It's the one who gives us healing. And then people ask us, oh, what do you talk about to God? How can you take 1 hour or 2 hours or 3 hours praying to God? What do you say? There's a lot of things to say. There's a family that you can pray for. There's situations that are happening all over the world that you can pray for. There are a lot of things that you can bring before God. Maybe your whole life, your siblings in your family. You can bring them before the Lord. Look to the Lord and his strength. Seek his face always.
set his face forward. That's why Moses, one thing he asked the Lord, he said, I want to see your face. I want to see you.
Amen.
Because the Bible says, when he saw the Lord and when he was coming back, people could not even see his face. He said, please, can you put a veil on your face? Because the glory is too much. When we see his face, it changes us. It changes us. We become like him in whatever we do. So number one is that prayer is more than a suggestion, it is a command. Number two, prayer is a perpetual and not mere occasion. And number three is that asking and receiving gives impulse and joy to the one who is praying. It gives you joy. In John chapter 16, verse 24, the Bible says, until now you have not asked for anything in my name. Ask and you will receive, and your joy will be complete. Amen.
Amen.
This is the goodness of the Lord to say. Amen. You know, if I want joy, if whatever I want in my life, I need to ask God. And imagine, even the kids, when you promise them, say, I'll bring you this. And then you bring it to them, see the joy. To say, oh my God, they have, he has given me this. Mm-hmm. And this is what the Father in heaven wants to do in our lives. Yeah. It's to bless us so that we are full of joy.
Mm-hmm.
So that we can go back to him again and again. Mm-hmm. He says, until now, you have not asked. Until now. So what is it that we want in our lives? Let's ask him. And when he gives us, we'll come back here with full of testimonies. We'll come to testify to the goodness of the Lord to say, wow, what the Lord has done for me, I cannot tell it all. You see, when somebody just escaped from something, the way they come, to say, no, I just want to thank God. Because what has just happened to me is so wonderful. I am spared. My life is spared. I thank God that I was almost dying. Now he has brought me back. Look at that joy. And that is the will of the Father.
Amen.
That he answers us so that we can come back to him and say, thank you.
Mm.
Remember the Bible says that he healed the 10 lepers and they went and only two came back.
Mm.
And then they came back rejoicing.
Mm. Amen.
You see, we are healed. Not only that, in the book of Kings, there are these lepers when they went out. Then God, he said, if we stay here, we die. So let's go into the Samaritan and see what will happen. The Bible says, as they were going, the Samaritan felt as if an army, a huge army is coming, and they ran away. And then they had all these foods that they want. They were eating the right sun. They said, no, what we are doing is not a good thing. Can we go back to Judah and tell them to say, there is a lot of food here? And he went in and told them the king and said, wow. And when they came back, they immediately saw the spoil and they collected everything. And there was food in Samaria.
Amen.
There was food. So this is what God will do. He wants to bless you and me. He wants to answer your prayers, not even on your own terms, but on his terms. Because the Bible says he makes all things beautiful in his
time.
So in his time, he makes all things. And when he does it, you can testify. When he does it, oh my God, I've been panicking, I've been stressing, but this is what God wanted me to have. And you have the peace of God.
Mm-hmm.
And you have the smile that when someone looks at you, what has happened to you? Mm-hmm. He said, you don't know what the Lord has done.
Mm-hmm.
God has done wonders in my life.
Amen.
This is what God wants. When praying no longer appears, God wants to answer
you. Amen.
God wants to give you whatever you desire.
Amen.
Until now, you have not asked. So ask him. Ask whatever you wish. Ask him. Ask the Father. Ask God. Do not just sit and say, oh, ask for me. I've been asking for years. It does not happen. No. Keep on asking. Keep on knocking the door.
Amen.
And the door will open. The Bible says, behold, I've set the door before you, walk in it. So there is something that you can do for you to open the door. Sometimes